team started out this season with singular goals to make it to the NCAA tournament. Dick, that business has been taken care of. Now it's time for the madness to begin in today's game between the Montana State Fighting Bobcats and the Duke Blue Devils. This is where both teams wanted to be, Dick. Let's not wait any longer to get this one started. The Blue Devils should be in for an easy one tonight, Dick. What do you see as the keys to their success?
The keys are very simple, my friend. First of all, pound the ball inside. Challenge their big men. Second of all, you got to pound the board. Boards lead to wins, baby. Lastly, make your team think defense first. Solid defense will lead to good offense.
Well, Dick, let's get down to the court and let's get the action underway. Dickie's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing them off.
Showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense. Dickie's still applying great pressure on the dribbler. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play. I love this guy, Hook. You cannot block that shot. He gets that ball in deep. Hey, Brown, why don't more guys use it?
Both teams looking to get things going here. He looks for the bomb. Tickles a twine. Fake. Dumps it in. Now the turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
And our trifecta for the night. Aaron Andrews on the sideline. And with Dick Vitale, I'm Brad Nessler. Nice to have you along with us. Looking for a screen on top and got it. For the bucket.
Great play to take that to the basket.
They look to get it to the inside. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
He hammers it home.
You can almost see that coming. They were a little bit lazy on a defensive end. Just your excitement with that jam.
Let's it fly. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
Right now, it's a one-man show. The other players need to step up.
Keeps the dribble as they regroup. On the dribble, gives it up. There's a high screen. He shoots from the top of the key.
Great job of freeing himself with the screen, but shot won't go. Trying to go inside.
He stole the ball. Great pressure there.
Fantastic ball pressure. The pressure got to the ball handler, and he lost it.
Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
Keeps the dribble as they set it up again. Come in the paint. His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
The ball goes out of play. Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, with the score so close, both teams seem so intense on their benches right now. Both coaches have told me it all comes down to turnovers and miscues.
Thanks, Aaron. He'll visit the charity stripe. Hits that one.
STOP. This place will be off the charts if they can get a stop here, Brad.
He's got the man in the high post if he can get it there. Trying to feed inside. Tries for two. Can't get the shot to drop. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot. Shooter spotting up on a three.
Gave it up. From the top of the circle, he gets it to go. Turns it over. If they can get a basket here, Dick, this crowd will erupt. Ivy receives the pass. Had a momentary look from three-point land. Defensively down on the low block, and there's a steal.
A terrific job anticipating, reading the offense, and making that steal.
The skip pass is picked off. Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset. In the paint. There's the pick. They are heating up this building with their shooting right now, Dick.
The hits just keep coming, baby.
Meek wants the crowd to get fired up and involved.
You know, Brad, he wants the fans back for this defensive possession.
Shot clock is dead. Well, that's good defense, a steal on the inside.
Oh, what a way to force the turnover. Great anticipation by the post player.
Goes up for two. Goes in. And the ball goes out of play. Points off turnovers, Dick, a stat I know coaches pay a lot of attention to.
Hey, Brad, it sure is. You want to limit your opponent's number of points off turnovers. Ultimately, you want to nullify the easy basket.
There's a nice block from behind, Dick.
Yeah, that's good timing for the defense.
At the half, the Bobcats are up by one. Dick, what would you say is the play of the half in this tightly knit affair?
This trifecta was the key for me, Brad. It opened up the game in the first half. It'll be interesting to see if they can keep up the outside shooting in the second.
Let's get back to the action and see what happens. Duke is practically handing the ball over to the opposing team like it's a Christmas present or something right now, Dick.
Hey, any team would gladly receive this kind of nice gesture. I bet they're not getting anything but a mouthful of criticism from their coaching staff.
Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
All right, thanks, Aaron. They're going to call this one a backcourt violation, Dick.
You can't make mistakes like that too often, Brad.
Dick, look at the number of points off turnovers.
I'll tell you, getting baskets off turnovers is such a great and easy way to score, Brad. You want to maximize these opportunities as much as you can.
That one, there should have been a foul called, I think.
Well, you take a look right there. I thought there was contact grab on the defensive player.
He fires from long range. He buries the shot. Both teams looking to get things going here. The power forward with the ball and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot. The defender's doing a great job of applying ball pressure.
He tries to knock down the three. These boys are slinging threes left and right, left, right, down the center every play.
Hey, they're going in from everywhere, baby.
That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin. I tell you, great shot. I don't understand why it's not utilized more often. It's so impossible to block that shot.
Trying to come up with a steal, and they do. Number three, while applying pressure, goes for the aggressive steal.
He's got to pick and choose, Brad. Pick and choose when to go for the steal.
Number 42 fakes the shot for two.
I love the sky hook, especially when you get great post position on the interior.
Meeks is animated and ready to go.
Yeah, no kidding, partner. When you have some success, you start to gain some confidence.
Kicks it out. Ivy handles the feed. He shoots from left of the circle. Off the rim and no good. Defensively, low block. Oh, nice job fronting him for the steal.
Terrific job creating the opportunity, and it really converts an offensive transition.
Executes the baby hook. Doesn't go. Boy, Boy, it's all elbows and shoulders down there, and I think the defense is winning, Dick.
I tell you, doing a great job in post defense. A lot of people don't realize that is an area that has to be taught, and this kid has responded in a positive way. STOP, this place will be off the charts if they can get a stop here, Brad.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, guys, after all, this is the NCAA Finals. In talking with both coaches before the game, they figured it would be a close game from start to finish. I'm certainly looking forward to the game's ending.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Oh, and you talk about a happy group of fans. Listen to this crowd.
Oh, there's all kinds of people standing and cheering and going wacky.
With the layup. Intercepts it. He hammers it home. That shot makes it a one-point contest.
Hey, it's anybody's game, baby.
So timeout on the floor, and that gives us a break to go courtside. Here's Aaron.
Well, Brad, this is a great opportunity for the coaches to calm their players down. I'm sure they're anxious, and they may be a little frazzled. Let's see how it all works out, guys.
Thanks, Aaron. We'll see if they've decided to go in another direction with things right here, Dick.
It wouldn't kill them to get a little diversity in their play right now.
This one is shaping up to be a barn burner, Dick.
In close games like this, Brad, offensive and defensive execution is very important.
On the outside, the point guard takes the feed.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
Number 44 with the fake. Goes up for two. Can't get the shot to go. Frierson handles the pass. Rims out. Tries for two. Up. Easy one. 3 points is the difference.
That's right. So somebody better guard New York.
Intercepted.
This is swarming defense.
Dick, you think they're going to stay this hot?
Hey, it doesn't look like they're slowing down, my friend.
We're ready to get back to the action. 5 points separate these two squads right now.
No one's leaving this building without a fight, Brad.
They're working around the perimeter. They work the perimeter. And the ball goes out of bounds. Mr. Vitale, how about that State Farm drive of the game?
Oh, Mr. Nestler, this one's superb. The ability to get close enough to the basket and then have the presence of mind to finish off the great play. Wow, what a play.
Well, it's time to start fouling. They got to stop the clock, Dick. Foul, and that stops the clock again.
Hey, now it's a matter of clock management, Brad. They have to foul in order to get back in this game.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock. Yet another foul. And the clock stopped with a foul. And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. And yet another foul. Dick, we all know how important it is to get to the free throw line.
Well, there's no doubt about it. I think it's such an unbelievable plus. It means you're playing aggressive basketball, you're playing attacking basketball, and you're creating all kinds of foul problems for the opponent.
Second one is good. Shot clock is dead. Isolated on the outside, they work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
Hey, if it wasn't for his play, that'd be in big trouble, Brad. Someone else needs to step up. If you want to know how aggressive a team is, you check to see how many times they go to the free throw line. That's a great indicator.
Makes the second.
A basket here will make this a two-possession game.
6 points separating these two squads.
This is no time to get complacent, Brad.
Something different here coming out of this timeout, Dick.
I wouldn't doubt it, Brad.
6 points is the difference.
Wow, do they need a basket badly, Brad? Momentum will decide it. They have to foul to put them on the line and hope they miss.
And the clock stopped with a foul. And we get a look here at our foul and timeout situation.
Hey, Brad, many games are lost because coaches fail to manage the clock, possession, and their timeout situation. Let's see how these coaches fare tonight.
He makes the front end of the one and one. Second shot, good.
A bucket here is crucial.
Go back out onto the floor. The three. He drains the bucket. And yet another foul. Well, Dick, there's a look at the foul situation.
Well, you know, Brad, a lot of times the first team to the bonus will get the advantage. That means they're playing aggressive basketball. It means they get to the charity stripe quicker and have an opportunity to rack up some easy points.
The second. They're shooting extremely well from the stripe tonight, Dick.
Yeah, they're making their coaches look good for making them shoot extra free throws every day.
Well, let's see who'll benefit the most out of that timeout, Dick. He had to hurry that one. Off the rim and no good. Well, Dick, sometimes statistics lie, but in this tournament game, I don't think they do. The better team won, and they're going on.
Well, I tell you, won this game, Brad, when you look at it and analyze it, because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
The Blue Devils is off to a strong start with an opening round victory here.
Hey, keeping the momentum will be crucial as they have one day off before they head back to the hardwood for their second round game.
So for Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.